Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. I'm about to make a video showing some of the stuff with the Nikon cameras and stuff. I haven't been able to make videos in the last few weeks because there's some very disturbing things that have happened. My good friend of 18 years has chosen to leave us. And it's a hard thing to think about. I'm not really sure what I'm going to say. A person comes to a very painful crossroads in their lives. Different churches, I'm a Christian guy, but different churches have different things to say, different rules and different theologies about something like that. But in the end, the pain is the pain, and it doesn't go away. And everybody that's involved goes through the same thing. Shoulda, woulda, coulda. What could I have done? I became friends with Matt as we did the transition from film to digital back in the 2000 area. And we were both in the same digital wedding forum association. And we met each other, and he chose to go Nikon, I chose to go Canon. We started communicating and we built up a friendship, and the friendship remained. We talked to each other for a long periods of time, daily and twice a day, because we both have YouTube channels. Matt has his YouTube channel called Art of the Image, which is still up. And when you go see it, or people that go see it, there will still be active links underneath. And that money will go to his children. There's two beautiful daughters in the area of 9 and 7. I'm not exact on that, okay? So it's painful for everybody. So there's not much I could tell you except that it hurts. I'm trying to be careful on what I say, and I'm trying to be careful not to lose my emotions. It's very hard. A person that I was able to speak to on a daily basis, or whatever it is. I spoke to, the last call I made was, I think, November 15th, and he chose to leave on Saturday, November 17. Things were discovered on Sunday, November 18th. Of course, by the time the discovery is made, it's too late. There's others on YouTube that have followed the same track and have caused a lot of pain. So let me talk to for a second to a person that might have this feeling inside that they don't count, they don't matter. We'd be better off if you weren't here. Your pain is too great and you can't take it. This comes in the form of depression. This comes in the form of something that creates or starts like a black hole, and eventually you arrive at a point where there's no hope. At that point, this is when you start to have thoughts like that. Now, I'm not talking to the general public right now. I want to speak to you, okay? If you do something like that, in a month or two, it'll be gone. Everything else will be going down the regular path of life. The sun will rise in the morning. The sun will go down in the evenings, okay? And you'll be gone, and you're no longer in the game. Whatever your brain or your heart is telling you in those moments is a lie. It's not the truth. Remember that. What your heart or what your brain is telling you in those moments, when you feel the world, your family, your friends would be better off without you, that your pain would be gone, that's a lie, because a month later or 2 months later, everything is different. Everybody has moved on, but you will not have moved on. So that's what I'm trying to get across to you. It's been a while now since this happened, and everything has moved on. The pain is there. You know, I still feel like getting a phone call from Matt or picking up my phone and calling him to talk about the video I'm going to make, and he's not there. So what's the point? Is he in a better place? Well, some people will say he's in a better place, but this is the place we're supposed to be. and what causes you to want to make that choice to leave is a lie. Get that down. It's a lie that you're lying to yourself. Believe that. Reach out to someone or get in a plane and fly to Russia, to a country where they can't reach you. Okay? Don't check out. It's the wrong choice. Remember those words. Now, for the rest of us that don't have those types of thoughts and never get to that hopeless spot in their life, be compassionate if someone reaches out. Guys, don't be so macho with each other. If somebody wants to say something to you, shut your mouth and listen, okay? There's not much you're going to be able to say, and listening is going to be a lot more important than you doing the macho thing, oh, F it, this, and you know, so on and so on. Shut up and listen to a person that wants to speak to you, okay? Girls, you're much more in tune with the feelings like that, but you still got to be careful. Now, I know there's nothing I could have done, but I don't feel like that. I feel like there's something that I could have done. I'm looking, you know, for clues, for hints, but if they're not wanted to be found out, they're going to hide it, all right? So that's why I have to speak to the person that feels that they're going to do something like that. It's a lie. It's a permanent solution to a temporary problem. It's a permanent solution to a temporary problem. Did you get that? It's a permanent solution to a temporary problem. And what you're believing is a lie that you're telling yourself. So I'm telling you right now, don't do it. Do not do it. All right? I really don't know what else to say. Matt's channel is still there, Art of the Image. He's my friend. I love him. I miss him. And it's time to say goodbye.